Hi friends, today let me start the session with a simple question. 394 plus 498 plus 98 sums to what? Here we'll round this off to the bigger number. 394 we'll round it off to 400, 498 to 500, 98 to 100. We have added 6 here, 2 here, and 2 here. Therefore, altogether we have added 10. And here the sum will be, sum of these rounded off numbers will be 1000. So, to get the original answers for these, 394 plus 498 plus 98, we should subtract 10 from 1000 and then we will get the answer as 990. That is 990. Okay. Hope you understood this logic. Let me move on to the next one. Next one is complements. Complements are numbers like 1 and 9. 1 and 9 are complements with respect to each other with respect to 10. That is 1 plus 9 you will get 10. Therefore 1 and 9 are complements to each other with respect to 10. 2 and 8 are complements. 3 and 7, 4 and 6, 5 and 5. It goes on like that. Likewise, we can find complements for 20, 30, etc. But the most important ones are complements of 10 and 100. Therefore, we'll find the complements for 100. 100's complement for 10 will be 90. 20 it will be 80. That is 20 plus 80 you will get 100. Therefore 100's complement of 20 will be 80. 30 it will be 70. Likewise it goes on. 100's complement will be useful in many additions. So we will go deep into that. We will try a new method to find the complements for 100. That is, an example I'll show you, that is 37. 37's complement. To find 37's complement for 100, we should first divide it into 2, that is 3 and 7. You should find 10's complement of 7. 10's complement of 7 will be 3. And we should write a number here, which when added to this, that is 3, you'll get an answer as 9. That is 6 and 3. 6 plus 3 will be 9. 7 plus 3 will be 10. Okay, so the complement for 37 is 63. Another example, 52. Put a slash. And the complement for 2 with respect to 10 is 8. 5 when added to 4 you will get as 9. So, the complement for 52, 100's complement for 52 is 48. Likewise, 36. 36. Here it will be 4 and here it will be 6. Okay. Now, you have to do some problems. You should find, you should take a number. First, you should take it as 2 and 3. Take it, let it be 3, 2 and 3. Keep it in mind and find the complement for 23. Then find the complement for 3 and 4. Then 5 and 6. Do this as a exercise. Okay. So we'll move on to the practical portion. That is where we are using these methods, complements. First, I'll give you an example and I'll show you how to solve it. Then I'll explain it. First example is 301 plus 422 plus 212 plus 108. First, take the ones place of all these numbers. You know what are the ones places. This is ones place, this is ones place, this is ones place, and this is ones place. This is 1's place, this is 10's place, and this is 100's place. Okay, so go to the 1's places of all these numbers. You will find complements for 10. Check. Yeah, here it is 2, and the complement for 10 will be 8. Therefore, you can add 2 plus 8 and you can write it as 10. Then 2 and 1, these are not complements, so we'll just add it and we'll write it as 3. 2 plus 1 is 3. So 3 plus 10, you will get 13 as the sum of all 1's digits in these numbers. So we'll write it as 13 here. Then we'll move on to the 10's digit. Here there is no 10's digit. Here it is 2. Here it is 1. 2 plus 1 it is 3. And here there is no 10's digit. Therefore 2 plus 1 3. 3 we will write. But as this was the sum of all 10's digits, you should add one more 0 here. Okay. Then we'll go to the 100's digits. Is there any complements? No, there is no complements. So we'll just add it. 3 plus 4 is 7. 7 plus 2, it will be 9. 9 plus 1 is 10. Okay, we'll write 10 here. But it was 100's digit which we were adding. So we'll add 2 more zeros here. And we'll write it as 3, 4, 1, 0. We'll add all these numbers and we'll get it as 3, 4, 0 and 1. This will be very useful in bigger digits when we are adding bigger numbers. Okay, so we'll go for the next example. Next example is 198 plus 222 plus 318 plus 421 plus 689 plus 382. Okay, so the numbers are 382, 198, 222, 318, 421 and 689. Now, we'll check for the 1's places. 1's places are 9, 1, 8, 2, 8, 2. So first we'll check for the complements. Is there any complements? Yes. 10's complement for 2 is 8 and it is here. Here also 2, it is 8, it is here. Then 1 and 9, it will be here. We'll write it as 10, 10, 10. We have 3 10's, so we'll add these all and we'll get it as 30. 30 is the sum of all 1's digits. Next we'll go to our 10's digits. 10's digit. 8 and 2. Here it is there. 8 and 2. 8 and 2. We'll get it as 10. 9. Yeah, 9. We are having 1 here. So we'll write as 10. Then 2 and 8. We'll write as 10. Okay, here also we have got 3 10's. Therefore, we'll write it as 30. But it was sum of 10's digits. Therefore, we should add one more 0 here. 300. And then, we'll add 3 plus 1 plus... There is no complements in this one. Yeah, here we are having one complement. 6 and 4. 6 and 4, we'll write it as 10. 3 and... No, there is no complements. Okay. 10, we'll keep in mind 10. Here 3 and 2, 10 plus 3 is 13, 13 plus 2 is 15, 15 plus 1 is 16, 16 plus 3 is 19. Okay, so we'll write 19 here, but we were adding the 100's digits, so we should put 2 more zeros, 19 and 2 more zeros. Now if we are adding these, we'll get it as 0. 3, 9 plus 3 is 12, 2, 2, 3, 0. Okay. Now, in the first sections, you should do it like this. Then afterwards, you can do it faster. You can add, you can just add this by keeping it in mind. 9 plus 1 here it is 10. 20, 30. 30. So we'll put one 0 here. Then 3 we'll keep it as a reminder. Then we'll go for the next digit. 8 and 2 it is 10. 10, 20, 30. 30 and here we were having 3. So we'll write 3 here. 30, the 3 we have kept in mind. And next we'll go to the last number. 10 plus 3, 13. 15, 16, 19. 19 plus 3 it is 22. So the answer is 2230. I think it is very fast and very easy. Okay, so we'll go on to the homework. See what you can do as part of my video. These are the questions. Pause the video and take a screenshot. Hope you people understood. You can see it clearly. Yeah. Take a screenshot. Thank you for watching my video. Bye. Have a great day.